What's up, Ronny, Rios?
What's up, Elie? How you doing?
I'm good. You got Eric De Leon in the house, Detroit. Eric's dad's in the house. ¿Cómo estás? You got your coach in the house. How you feeling, coach?
Tired.
Why?
Fucking freezing in.
Yes, it is. Are you excited about your big fight?
Yeah, very excited.
It's a big one.
Yeah.
You sparred Brandon in the past, Brandon Rios. What did you make of his fight with Danny Garcia?
Man, he was looking good. So he got caught. He got a little lazy. He was doing really good. Put in good pressure. It's part of the game.
But he showed he has a lot left.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Showed a lot of heart.
Another person you sparred? You also sparred Mikey Garcia.
Beast.
What is that like?
Mikey's one of my favorite fighters.
Why?
Everything he does in the ring, you know. You learn a lot from him.
You know, Ronnie also sparred Mikey. It was great sparring.
We sparred with Mikey for years when Mikey was a little bit smaller.
Well, Mikey was 126, of course.
Yeah. No.
Now Mikey's might fight Thurman, might fight Danny Garcia next.
Good fight. I think Thurman would give him a little bit more trouble, but I think with Danny, I think Mikey destroys him.
What about Mikey Crawford?
That would be tough. Crawford's got the reach, height, but I think Mikey just has a fine. He finds a way to win. I remember when they fought in the amateurs. We were there. I had Luis Ramos at the time, and he lost to Crawford, I believe, in the U.S. men's back in like 2006, I believe, if I'm not mistaken.
But they're both at different fighters, different size, different.
Oh, yeah.
A lot has changed. But
Alexis sparred. We sparred with Crawford a few months ago.
How talented is Crawford?
He's good. Puts his punches together, strong. He's smart. He's very smart and very hard to hit.
Okay, Crawford against Errol Spence.
That's a tough one. That'd be a nice fight.
Okay, Crawford, Keith Thurman.
Crawford.
Crawford.
Why?
Just boxing. Skills. Speed.
Yeah,
lefty, right handed, everything. You do it all.
Well, neither of them have ever lost, so we want to see it.
And he's been active, he's been fighting.
Crawford's been fighting much tougher opponents, and he's been doing this in his career. Keith also did this, but I think Keith's got a little bit more holes. Ask him, he sparred with Crawford.
You sparred Crawford? What was that like?
Big experience, man.
Why? What makes him so good?
He's ranging. The fool can hit you from anywhere, honestly.
Where do you rank his power? Terrence Crawford's power?
He has some power.
He has some pop?
Yeah, he has
but
pop.
Like how much? Like,
70.
Did it impress you?
I mean, it's grown man strength. Yeah.
What footwork most impressive? The intelligence,
oh, yeah.
Like what?
Yeah, intelligence. That's overall his boxing IQ right there. That's what makes him great.
Yeah. If he fights Errol Spence, what do you think?
That's a hard one. I don't
know. Okay. Him against Mikey.
That's a hard one against, man.
Him against Thurman.
Probably Crawford.
It's funny. Your coach said the same thing.
Yeah.
Hey, they're giving me the same answers. Did you learn anything sparring Terrence Crawford? Because he's a very smart fighter.
Just give me different angles. This guy comes from anywhere.
And he switches on you.
Yeah, he switches on me. So that was
is
very
it awkward.
Yeah, that was very awkward. But like I said, he's rangy. He's boxing IQ. He's good. The times are very good. Yeah.
You know, Ronnie looks like the Mexican Conor McGregor.
Yes.
Oh, because the beard?
No, the beard, the face.
Actually, I have some red in here, too.
All right, hold on. Let me ask somebody else with that opinion. Brandon, who does, like, which MMA fighter does Ronnie Rios look like? Ronnie, look this way for a second.
Orlovsky?
Conor McGregor.
Conor McGregor. This is Orlovsky.
Orlovsky, yeah, you do look like him, too. His name is the Pitbull.
Yeah.
He has fangs. So you came to spar today?
Yes, sir.
You have a big fight, March 9th?
Yeah, against Zah.
Tell everybody where they could go.
OC Hanger.
OC Hanger?
March 9th.
You and your brother are headlining?
Yeah. I'm the main event. I think he might be the opening bout or the co-main event. Yes.
Are you fighting for a belt or a title?
It's for the WBC. Continental.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Good job. Hey, listen, you're a veteran. You've been doing this for a long time.
You know what? Everyone keeps saying that, man, but I still feel like a young guy, man.
Good.
I still feel like a young, hungry, motivated fighter that's still learning, you know, day by day. So I'm only 20. I just turned 28, man, last month, so I'm still a baby.
I know, but I remember you at 17, at 16, so I'm saying it's been a long time.
It's been a long time, but it's been good, you know. It's been a good long road. Obviously, we've had our ups and downs, but at the same time, it's all called experience, you know?
Look, Abner Morris, you, I think, are Charles Horto's back now. But you guys started like eight of you, and it's only like three, four left now.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, there's actually, who else started? Yeah, there's actually only three. And, you know, I've never sparred with Abner, but I've sparred with Charles Horto countless times. So, yeah, we're good friends. I'm good friends with Abner too, but never had the experience of sparring with them, though.
All right, tell people where to follow you if they're watching.
I'm on Instagram, Ronny Rios. I forgot that. Is it underscore something?
All right, find them. FaceNewsReporting.com, Elie Seckbach reporting. Does he look like Orlovsky or Connor?